Hey everyone! Flipper Zero applications typically use the text input module to allow users to input data. As you can see here, each firmware has its own text input implementation, exposing a subset of available characters. For example, on official firmware, it doesn't expose the at or dot symbols for entering an email address. In this video, we'll look at how to leverage the momentum implementation in your Flipper Zero application, and we'll put it in a mode that exposes all 7-bit printable ASCII characters. Let's get started. Please see my code playlist for how to set up your development environment with Visual Studio Code and learn how to make Flipper Zero applications. Also, check out my GitHub Flipper Zero tutorial repository. Under UI, Basic Scenes is a tutorial that explains how to use the text input module. See the comments for links. In this video, we'll be modifying the HHBIR app. This application was written for DEF CON's Hard Hat Brigade, and it allows a user to enter a message, which is then sent using the Flipper Zero's infrared to a hard hat accessory. Using the default text input module, official firmware users can't send symbols to their hard hat. As I mentioned before, we'll be leveraging the Momentum keyboard code. You'll need to either clone the Momentum firmware using Get Tools or download the zip and extract it to your computer. Right-click on your project, choose New Folder in Visual Studio Code, and then type MNTM Input for Momentum Input. Next, in File Explorer, open the Momentum firmware folder, and then navigate to Applications, Services, GUI, Modules. We're going to copy 4 files, the text input files and the validators files. Drag those over into the Momentum input folder. In your application code, comment out the pound include for GUI modules text input.h. and add a pound include for quote momentum input / text input.h quote. The quotes will use our local files instead of using the firmware files. Once you've made that change, go to Terminal, Run Task, Launch App on Flipper, and you should see a bunch of errors in red. Most of those errors are about missing icon files with I underscore in the file name that's missing, but you'll also see an error about ASCII callback. We'll go ahead and click on that one, and then we'll comment out the text input view ASCII callback function. This function is what allows a branch of the Momentum queue flipper to be able to type input onto your Flipper Zero, but I'm not aware of anyone using that custom QFlipper implementation. Next, we'll click on the next error, and it's actually 2 lines lower because we just added 2 lines for comments, and we'll go ahead and comment out the call to view set ASCII callback. At this point, we're ready to go back up and go to Terminal, Run Task, Launch App on Flipper, and this time all the errors we see are about missing icons. Next, we'll open our application.fam file, and this application is currently not using any icon assets. So we'll add a new line for FAP underscore icon underscore assets equals quote assets quote comma. This is where it'll look for asset images. Next, we'll right click on our project, go to new folder, and we'll create that assets folder. If your project already has a folder for icon assets, you'll use that instead for the next step. In Momentum firmware, open the assets folder, icons folder, and then the keyboard folder. Looking at the errors, I believe we only need a subset of these images, but I'll go ahead and select all of them and drag them into the assets folder. Back in our application.fam, I'll copy our app ID to the clipboard And then in text input.c, I'll replace it assets of assets underscore icon with our app ID. So HHB underscore IR underscore app underscore icons.h. Go to terminal, run task, launch app on Flipper. And this time we're down to just one error about warning dolphin 45 by 42. In our assets folder, we'll go to icons, and then in icons, we'll go to dolphin. And again, we're looking for the 4542. So we'll copy that one into our assets folder. There's our dolphin. I'll go ahead and close that. And then terminal, run task, launch app on Flipper. And this time, make sure that QFlipper is not running and that your Flipper Zero is plugged in. And then once that's installed, you'll be able to use the new keyboard. When we do show symbols, you'll see we still have that 0 to 9 keypad on the right, which we'll address in a moment. But for now, we can go ahead and type in some test text. And I can now add symbols on official firmware. So I'll go ahead and add an exclamation mark. And one other thing we can do is press up again, and we can now use left and right to insert text within our typed text. So this is super helpful to be able to edit and backspace out in the middle of your text. Clicking save will send that IR signal with symbols on official firmware. Next, we want to replace that 0 through 9 on our symbols keyboard. So we'll search our code for text input alloc and text input reset. After a text input reset or text input alloc, we'll call text input show illegal symbols, passing our text input object and a true value for show. I want to be clear here that illegal symbols are just symbols that are not allowed in file names. That's why it's called illegal symbols. Everything we're doing with the Flipper Zero in this video is perfectly legal. We'll also call that function after our text input alloc call. And we'll pass a true as well for show. Go to terminal, run task, launch app on Flipper. Make sure the application is not currently running on your Flipper Zero, that your Flipper Zero is plugged in, and that QFlipper is closed. Once that's done, we'll open up QFlipper and we'll go ahead and type in a message. And now when we go over to symbols, we see all of those symbols are on our keyboard. Every printable character in 7-bit ASCII is now available for our application to send to our hard hat. Go ahead and click on save, and it just sent with those special symbols. We can also now click the back button, and then we can edit our message. Hopefully in the future, all firmwares will expose all characters. But until then, you now know how to add the momentum keyboard to your application, allowing users to type in whatever characters they need. Please like and subscribe, and if you have any questions, please leave them below or contact me on Discord.